In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a rough surface texture without using a displace modifier. There are two disadvantages when using this set of nodes, and they are noticeable slowness issue, and the cycles engine compatibility. If we enable the full nodes, the final material is going to be visible, but the previous set of nodes material won't show up in cycles. To avoid the slowness issue, we could either use the wireframe mode when rotating the view, or turn off the bump node. I'm not sure what is causing the slowness, because I'm using a default cube and my PC's spec is not low end. Now my PC is almost frozen. The CPU's resource meter goes up to 100% when the freezing issue occurs. I wouldn't recommend using this set of nodes, unless if you're planning to produce a rocky texture render image like above. The freezing issue occurs only when the bump node is added to the scene, and the material loses the 3D look when the node turns off. I wanted to show you this, because we can alternatively use the usual displace modifier without the bump node to prevent this issue. The displace modifier doesn't produce this issue at all, and it's much faster than the bump node method. Pressing Ctrl, Z, to undo won't bring back the old settings either. Let me show you what happens when I use the Cycles renderer. If I were to use the Displace modifier instead, this issue would not have occurred. For some reason, if I activate all the nodes, the material will appear in cycles and I won't know how that is possible, to be honest with you. It appears the slowness issue only occurs with EV. Anyway, I'll show you the full nodes. I'm thinking the slowness issue is none other than an EV bug. This is without the bump node, and we've lost the 3D look. Once we regain the 3D look, the slowness issue will start to occur. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.